Hi students, good evening to one and all. Now welcome back our favorite video channel Sri Ganit Vijnana Sarvasvam. Now today, this time we have to discuss the topic is application of derivatives, Junior Inter Mathematics 1B paper. In previous class, some more problems discussed here. That is large answer type questions in tangent and normals. Now here also, continue the same subtopic of application of derivatives. Now, in that one, the next problem. So here, if the tangent at any point P on the curve x power m y power n equal to a power m plus n. Here the curve is x power m into y power n value equals to a power m plus n. Here the product of mn, that is mn, which is always not equal to 0. Now meets the coordinate axis. Now the curve meets the coordinate axis in A and B. Now here the tangent of the curve at the point P meets the coordinate axis in A and B. Then show that the condition is AP is PB is constant. Here to prove the result is the ratio AP is PB is constant. Now here, first of all, here we take the curve x power m y power n equal to a power m plus n. So in that, now we are going to solution given that the curve is x power m into y power n equal to a power m plus n. Here mn is always non-zero. The product of m and n is always non-zero. Now here first to find equation of tangent. Before going to find equation of tangent, first to find slope of the tangent. Now here we have to differentiate with respect to x. Now differentiate with respect to x on both sides. We have here this is the product of u and v. Now we take u v whole s. So first function into second function derivative and second function into first function derivative. So here already written u v whole s equals to first function u into v dash plus second function v into u dash. So this is our derivative of product of two functions. Now using the result, we have x power m into derivative of y power n, that is n into y power n minus 1, and also differentiate y with respect to x, that is dy by dx, plus the second function y power n into first function derivative m into x power m minus 1, that equals to here derivative of x is 1. So in right side we have to observe a power m plus n, so which is always constant. Now derivative of any constant can be taken as 0. Now here the value of RHS is 0. Now here we have to take the term y power n into m into x power m minus 1 to right side. Now here we write n into x power m into y power n minus 1 into dy by dx, which is always equals to, here we take minus of m into y power n into x power m minus 1, that is the negative term. So here we take n into x power m into y power m minus 1 to right side, dy by dx, which is always equals to minus, here we write m by n separately, and also here we write x power m y power n. So here we write y power n by y power n minus 1. Similarly we write x terms separately, x power m minus 1 by x power m. Now in that clearly we have to observe, it can be simplified that minus of m by n Here y power n minus 1 can be taken into numerator. Then we write y power n minus n plus 1. So this is y power n minus 1. It can be taken to numerator. Then we take this is my the power is negative. So minus n plus 1. Minus of n minus 1 means minus n plus 1 into whole by here we write x power m minus we take this power numerator power can be taken to denominator. This is the negative m minus m plus 1. Now it can be simplified that minus of m by n into here n and cancel in that denominator m will be cancelled. Then we write y by x. So this is the derivative of the curve dy by dx. Now here to find equation of tangent at any point P. Now here we take let P of x1 y1 be any point on the curve. Now here we take the curve is equation 1. Now the dy by dx is equation 2 on the curve. Equation 1. Now clearly in that we have to write from 1 x1 power m into y1 power n equal to a power m plus n. Similarly here to find derivative of here to find slope of the tangent here to find slope of the tangent to the given curve. Now clearly from equation 2 slope of tangent slope of tangent to equation 1 equals to dy by dx at p of x1 y1 dy by dx at p of x1 y1. Now here the value of dy by dx is minus m by n y by x. Now here y and x can be replaced by x1 y1. Here we substitute x1 y1 in the place of y and x. So let it be taken as the slope m equals to here we write minus m into y1 by n into x1. So this is the slope. Now using this slope to find equation of tangent. So therefore equation of tangent at P of x1 y1 with slope m is y minus y1. So here we take point slope formula y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. Now which implies here x1 y1 does not change y minus y1 equal to minus m y1 by n x1 into x minus x1. Now clearly in that we take m y1 to left side here we divide y by m y1 minus y1 by m y1. In right side also divide with minus 1 by nx1 multiply with minus 1 by nx1 to x and x1. Now we write minus x by nx1 minus of minus plus x1 by nx1. Now here first of all completely you know this solution. After that we have to explain the remaining solution. So in that we have to observe. So in left side in the second term y1 will be cancelled. In right side the second term x1 will be cancelled. Now we take minus x by nx1 to right side to left side. Then we take x by nx1. Here also y minus y by my1 is there. Now we take a y by my1, and also here minus 1 by m is there in left side. Now we take right side. Here already 1 by n is there. Now we write 1 by m plus 1 by n. Now in that, clearly we observe this is m plus n by mn. Here we take cross multiplication. 1 into n, n plus 1 into m, m. N plus m or m plus n by mn. So this is clearly which is equals to x by nx1 plus y by my1. Now this is the equation of tangent. This is the equation of tangent. Now here this tangent can be converted to intercept form. Now here we have to observe in that right side value constant m plus n by mn totally divide with m plus n by mn 2 on both sides. So divide with m plus n by mn on both sides. We have here we write x by nx1 into m plus n by mn plus y by my1 into m plus n by mn equals to here m plus n by mn whole by m plus n by mn. Now in that n will be cancelled, m will be cancelled. So here x by already n will be cancelled. Then we write m plus n by m into x1 plus y by m plus n by n into y1 equal to 1. Now these are cancelled. So which is intercept form? Which is intercept form. So here, now here we can take, this is equation 3. Here, x intercept is a equals to m plus n by m into x1. Similarly, y intercept is b equal to m plus n by n into y1. Now this is the intercept form. Here these two are x intercept and y intercept. So this curve meets x and y coordinates in a and b. Now we take one diagram. So this is given curve. Here we draw one tangent line. So this is x axis, this is y axis, this is origin. Now the point, this is the P of x1, y1. So this is the curve. X power m into y power n equal to a power m plus n. Now here, this is the tangent, equation 3. Now equation 3 is the equation of tangent. Now this tangent meets coordinate axis at A and B. Now here the points are, so here given condition, since equation of tangent meets coordinate axis at A and B, then A equal to the point A, which is clearly lies on the x-axis. Now here y coordinate 0. Now x coordinate is x-intercept. M plus n by m into x1 comma 0. This is coordinate of A. So B vertex means here y coordinate is 0 because of B is lies on y-axis. So 0 comma y into z, m plus n by n into y1. Now here clearly we have to observe a value is m plus n by m into x1 comma 0, b value is 0 and m plus n by n into y1. Now we have to find the ratio AP is to PB. So here the point P is x1 comma y1. So here using one more important result, that is suppose A can be taken x1 y1, B can be taken x2 y2 and P can be taken xy. Here the ratio of AP is PB can be taken to x1 minus x is to x minus x2, x1 minus x is to x minus x2, or y1 minus y is to y minus y2. So these are two results. So you can choose one result, that is the ratio result. Here also three points are there. Here we have to observe, this is x1, this is y1, this is x2, this is y2, this is x, this is y. Now here we write the ratio AP is PB equals to x1 minus x. X1 means m plus n by m into x1 minus x. X means x1. Is to x minus x2. X2 means 0. So here x means x1. Now in that, here we take common x1, m plus n by m into m minus 1 into x1 by x1 minus 0 means x1. Here the ratio can be written as fraction form. Here x1 will be cancelled and here we take LCM m, then we write m plus n minus m by m, m plus n minus m by m is to 1. Here m will be cancelled. Here n by m is to 1. Now it can be taken as n is to m. N is to m. So this is the ratio. Now clearly we observe the ratio, in that ratio only n and m is there. Now n and m are constants. Now clearly the ratio is also constant. Now we take which is constant. So this is our proving result. Now in that, to show that AP is to PB is always constant, here to find the ratio AP is to PB, using these three points, substitute in that formula x1 minus x is to x minus x2. Now here x1 means m plus n by m into x1 minus here x means x1. Here x means x1 is to x minus x2. X means x1 minus x2. Now we take in B coordinate, x2 value is 0. Now here we take common x1, then we write m plus m by m minus 1 into x1 by x1. Here the ratio can be written as in fraction form. X1 will be cancelled. Now we take LCM, m plus m minus 1 into m minus m whole by m is to 1. Again we write in ratio form. Now in that, m will be cancelled, n by m is 1 is there. Now we write ratio form, n is to m. Here multiply with m to both the terms. Now we write n is to m. Now this is always constant, which is the constant. Now the ratio will be constant. This is our proving result. Now write this solution completely. Now the next problem, show that the area of the triangle formed by the tangent at any point on the curve xy equal to c with the coordinate axis is constant. Here also, first of all, to find equation of tangent, and also it will be converted to intercept form. Now the tangent makes a triangle with the coordinate axis. Now here the area of the triangle, the area of the triangle is always constant. Now first to find equation of tangent to the given curve xy equal to c. So first of all, we have to take given curve is xy equal to c. Now here the constant c is always not equal to 0, which is equation 1. Now differentiate with respect to x on both sides. We have here the product of x uv. Now using uv hold as formula, here we write uv hold as equal to first function u into second function derivative v dash plus second function v into first function derivative u dash. Now here we write x into y derivative dy by dx plus y into x derivative 1. Here the constant c, derivative of constant equals to 0. Now in that we write dy by dx equals to, here y can be taken to right side, that is minus y. Now x can be taken to denominator, that is x. So this is the dy by dx. Now here first to find slope of the tangent to the given curve. Now let here we take the tangent at any point. Let P of x1 y1 be any point on the curve, any point on the curve. Here we substitute x1 y1 in equation 1, then x1 y1 equal to c. Now which is equation 2. So this is equation 2, this is equation 3. Now here at the same point we have to find equation of we have to find slope of the tangent. Also slope of the tangent at px1 y1, which is always equals to dy by dx at p of x1 y1. Now the value of this one from equation 2, we write slope m equals to, it can be taken to m, minus y1 by x1. So this is the slope. Now here to find equation of tangent, equation of tangent at p of x1 y1 with slope m is, here also using slope point form, y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. Here x1 y1 does not change. Now we substitute the slope of m, the slope m is minus y1 by x1. Now here we write y minus y1 equals to minus y1 by x1 into x minus x1. Now here y1 can be taken to left side, then we write y by y1 minus y1 by y1 equals to minus x by x1 plus x1 by x1. Now in that y1 will be cancelled in left side, right side x1 will be cancelled. We write x by x1 plus y by y1 equals to, this is 1. Now this is also minus 1, it can be taken to left right side, total value is 2. Now x by x1 plus y by y1 equal to 2. So here The equation of tangent is y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus y1 equal to minus y1 by x1 into x minus x1. Now here y1 can be taken into left side. Now here it can be written in denominator y by y1 minus y1 by y1. In right side multiply with minus 1 by x1 to x and x1. So minus x by x1 minus into minus plus x1 by x1. Now here clearly we have to observe y1 cancel, x1 cancel. Now we write x by x1 plus y by y1. Here this is minus 1. It can be taken to right side. Total value 1 plus 1 is 2. Now divide with 2. Then we write x by 2x1 plus y by 2y1 equal to 1. So which is intercept form? Which is intercept form? Now this equation of tangent makes one triangle, formed one triangle with coordinate axis. Now here we take one diagram. This is one diagram. This is the tangent line. This is the curve. Now this is the point P. So this is A, this is B. Now equation of tangent, since which is equation 3, this is equation 4. Since equation 4 form a triangle with coordinate axis, then area of triangle OAB. Now the formula is 1 by 2 mod x1, sorry, 1 by 2 mod AB. So here A is x intercept, B is y intercept. So x intercept is 2x1, B, y intercept is 2y1. Now we substitute in that one, 1 by 2 mod A means 2x1 and B means 2y1. Now in that 2 will be cancelled, then we write 2 into x1 y1. But clearly we have to observe from equation 3, x1, y1, the product x1, y1 value is c. Now here substitute 2 into c. So from equation 3, the product x1, y1 is c because of the point x1, y1 is lying on the curve, then x1, y1 equals to c. We substitute x and y, replaced by x1 and y1, that is x1, y1 equal to c. Now this is c. Clearly we observe c is the constant. So where this is c is not equal to 0. Now here area can be taken to 1 by 2 AB mod AB square units. Now here 2c is square units. 2c is the always constant. So this equals to constant. Now in our problem, our proving result is area of the triangle found by the tangent at any point on the curve xy equal to c is the constant, with coordinate axis is the constant. So here clearly we have to prove the area of the triangle OAB is constant. So this is the complete solution for this question. Write down this complete solution and prepare well these two solutions, and in the next video the remaining sums, angle between the curves sums, can be discussed here. So thank you. Wish you all the best.